Welcome to this special senior edition of the Jungle News. I'm your host, Trevor Davis. We have a great show for you tonight. We have comedy, we have people making fools of themselves, we have drama. We even have people revealing some little secrets about themselves as well.
You suck.
Hey! People are tired on this! It's a challenging job to do. This first video, it's awards they're giving. You know what the award you'd get? Biggest Jerk Award, man! And this is my job, this is what I do, this is what I want to do for a living.
Not anymore. You're fired.
Bo Humphrey, Bo, today you have won the Blue Jacket Award for most fit in the senior class. How does that make you feel, sir?
Well, it's an absolute honor. I feel appreciated, all my hard work. Really,
you help.
Yeah. Yeah, all the hard work and time I put in.
Yes. All the. My button is set.
Yeah, we'll get that. I work a strict diet every day. It's an all carb diet. I get up in the morning, I run about a quarter mile, then I run back. I make sure I stay in the top physical condition. I'm in the best condition of my life right now. I'm headed towards a life of physical fitness. I intend to be stronger than Arnold.
Sir, you are an inspiration to all.
I try to be.
Thank you.
Ethan McBean, you have won the Blue Jacket Award for sexiest legs in the senior class. How does that make you feel, sir?
Well, you know, it makes me feel like all my hard work I've put in towards building these sexy legs, and it's really paid off. All the 5,000 calf raises a day, squatting like 500 times a day with like 300 pounds, and all of that has just really helped me, and that's why I have the legs I do today, and I accredit that to nobody but myself.
For the beginners,
just try your best. I mean, you're probably not going to be like able to get legs like this, but I mean, everything else is just work hard and do your best.
Congratulations.
Nick Sims, stand up, sir. You've been awarded the Blue Jacket Award for the best seizure in the 2015 class. How does that make you feel?
It feels absolutely amazing. It feels so good. I love it.
Here we are, folks. Rachel Ritter, you have been awarded the Blue Jacket for biggest airhead.
Oh, what's that? Like the candy?
No, Rachel, it's an award that you get.
Thanks.
Reds. Oh, Cole Wilson. You have won the Blue Jacket Award for best Reds fan. Put this on, boy. How do you feel about that?
Ridge.
Any encouraging words for your fans?
Ridge, you're good.
Congratulations, buddy. Worth it. this your whole life.
Ridge.
Excuse me, sir, you're not that important right now. Mr. Woods, you have won the Blue Jacket Award for Best Test Taker. How does that make you feel?
Oh my god.
Yeah. You got any shout outs or any supporters you like?
That's my biggest supporter right there, Catfish.
Get in here, young sir.
Catfish Billy, on the grillie, cook it up, make a millie, acting stupid, acting silly.
Here we are, folks. Skylar Woods, you have won the Blue Jacket Award for most fun in the woods. How does that make you feel, sir?
I feel blessed. I'm glad to be here. I spend a lot of time in the woods. The reds are in the woods. The turkeys are in the woods. Good feelings in the woods.
Your last name's Woods.
My last name is indeed Woods.
This doesn't fit anybody better than you, sir.
I agree.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Zach Chapman. It's a surprise seeing you in there, buddy. You have won the Blue Jacket Award for best swimmer in the high school. How do you feel how do you feel about that, young sir?
I like to thank God and all my friends, family, because they support me, and all my haters. Haters are my motivators, so peace out.
This next video is stupid or funny faces. I made a monkey face in the video, but was later told that there was no need for me to make that face because my face is so stupid and god-awful looking. Wait, what? Who wrote that? My face looks completely normal.
At first I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. And so you're back from outer space. I just walked in to find you here without that look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you leave you here. If I had known for just 1 second you'd be back to bother me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome.
So I wanted to make a career out of hosting senior videos, but Mr. Linkswiler told me I'd never work in this industry again. So, let me take a pause for the cause, and see if anyone else has dreams that can be crushed by the devil.
Now I've got a confession. How for my future plans, I have chose to go to Findlay University, and I'll be there for 4 years, majoring in nursing, and then after that, I'm going to go work in a hospital for about 2 years, specializing in maternity and or pediatrics, and then I'll go back to school for 2 years to get my master's, which is like physician's assistant.
Well, I actually plan on going to the Air Force, but probably end up blowing my knee out for the 8th time, then have to leave, and live on the side of the street in a box. So that's my future.
I am going to the University of Dayton to be a computer engineer, probably going to get a master's in 4 years on the way they have their system structured, maybe do some co-ops, make some money. I am very greedy and I like the smell of cash. Then from then, there, I'll go to a law school, get a law degree so I can become a patent attorney and make even more money, because like all stereotypes, I love money very
future
much.
Future plans are going to Wilmington for 2 years and then OSU for agriculture and environmental science. And then I'm going to plan to live in New York to work with inner city kids and how to grow their own food and get out in nature.
I'm going to the University of Akron studying pre-med, and then I'm going to go to med school somewhere wherever they accept me and become a surgical pediatric oncologist and have Bulgarian babies, as many as I can.
I'm going to Bluffton University and studying early education, and I'm also going to be a cheerleader for their football squad.
My future plans is to go to Wright State for our education, and I'm also cheering at Wright State.
My future plans are to drop out of Urbana University after 2 years and go to Silicon Valley in California and be the CEO of Google. And then where I'll run the company into the ground and take the money and move to Oregon and live on Crater Lake. And that's all I want
to
do.
I want to go to Miami University. I want to major in art. I would like to illustrate children's books, maybe. Maybe get married, be successful, have kids.
I'm going to find Be Holy.
I'm going to Cedarville University, and I'm majoring in graphic design. And I think it'd be really cool to design movie posters.
So, I'm going to Calvin College in the fall. It's in Michigan. And I am majoring in pre-med with the hopes of becoming a pediatric surgeon.
I'm going to Cedarville University next year. I'm going to major in nursing and possibly minor in cross-cultural nursing. So that'll help me in the future with missionary work. I don't really know what kind of nursing I want to go into, but hopefully college will help me figure that out. So.
My future plans are to go to Wilmington for 4 years and become a teacher. I want to play softball there too.
So I'm going to go to High State for 4 years, and I'm going to major in animal clubbing and probably go to Antarctica and specifically club seals, because that's the best type of clubbing there is.
My future plans are, I'm looking forward to becoming a male model or possibly a bounty hunter named Cinnamon Spice.
My plans for the future is that I'm going to kick this guy in the shin, and then I'm going to go eat a bagel.
So my future plans to, for later on in life are to become a ballerina. I'll probably change my name to something like Greece, and just to showcase some of these talents. And that's how it's done.
Plan on going to a power lineman school in Piqua. Starts in November. I graduate from that in May and then get a good job without going to college for 4 years.
So you think you look like someone famous? Did you not make the cut for this video? That means someone doesn't think you're important enough. So what you need to do is write your congressman and tell him how you feel.
My house in Budapest, my hidden treasure chest, golden grand piano, my beauty focus EOU. Ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. My acres of a land, I've achieved. It may be hard for you to stop and believe, but for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Over you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you want me, then all of this will go away. artifacts, the list goes on. If you just say the words, I'll up and run. Oh, to you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd leave it all. Oh, to you, ooh, ooh, I'd leave it all. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you want me, then all of this will go away. Give me one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you want me, then all of this will go away. Friends and family, they don't understand. They fear they'll lose so much if you take my hand. But for you, ooh, you, ooh, I'd lose it all.
Do you have a weird talent? Like that squirrel that can water ski? Wow, that squirrel's got talent. Unlike me, who has none.
You got that right, buddy.
Okay, but let's look at the talent our senior class has.
Donut in 2 seconds.
I can dunk these two donuts.
What a great montage. You know, we got montages.
Montage! don't know how you met me. You don't know why you can't turn around and say goodbye. All you know is when I'm with you, I make you free and swim through your veins like a fish in the sea. I'm singing, follow me, everything is alright. I'll be the one to tuck you in at night. And if you want to leave, I can guarantee you won't find nobody else like me. I'm not worried about the ring you wear, 'cause as long as no one knows, then nobody can care. You're feeling guilty, and I'm well aware, but you don't look ashamed, and baby, I'm not scared. I'm singing, follow me, everything is alright. I'll be the one to tuck you in at night, and if you want to leave, I can guarantee.
Do you have a great memory of high school? I was just looking back at a few in my diary. Well, see, I remember this one time, I was at camp with this dude, and we did math. I mean, like, hard calculus math. Like, it was really, really cool. Actually, you know, now that I think about it, that's the exact opposite of cool. That's the... Oh my god, I just remember what that camp was called. It was called Nerd Camp. I'm a nerd. A fat nerd.
Nerd!
He's so right. By God, he's right.
Zach Eno, because he's my boyfriend and he's moving far away to Rio Grande, and I'm going to miss him because we hung out a lot and he's really fun to be around.
Playing sports with my sister because she's such a big influence in getting the other girls just to push me harder and make me work.
Definitely going to miss cheering with the seniors, and it's going to be different next year being leaders and not having anyone to look up to.
I'll probably miss their leadership and like the bond that we had with them. I mean, I'm excited to be a senior and all, but that class, there were so many of them and there's so many great leaders. So, that's going to be a big part of our sports that we're losing.
Be holy.
What I'll miss most about this year's senior class is probably my sister. She was a big influence on me this year, setting good examples, and I just miss her. I'm going to miss my sister most of all. She's a big influence on me, and I really honestly just can't wait for her to leave as well. But I'll miss her. I'll miss her some, but not too much.
Just like the leadership that they had and like the bonds that we had together and like all the things that we did.
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Senior season of soccer, because not only did we win the OHC for the first time in history, but we also just had like a great senior class that just really came together, and we just kind of led as a team, and it was really like the closest I've ever felt like our soccer team. We were just kind of one in like a whole.
Like, my senior year, we got Coach Mack's 300th win, which was kind of cool just because, like, he coached my aunts, and it was cool that, like, that family-oriented kind of atmosphere, I guess.
I think it was probably a few years ago at lunch when we were messing around with my friends, and we were throwing a water bottle at Bo, and he was getting mad. And he slapped it across the room, and it drilled Officer Phil in the back of the head.
I see a man. Wealthy, successful, fit, overall well-liked, just an awesome guy. Oh wait, that's my future. But let's look into the orb and see what your future holds.
In 5 years, I see Kylie Orman at Hogwarts experimenting with new herbs and just picking herbs and organic foods every day.
All right, I think Eli Woodruff's going to be the dictator of the state of Oaxaca in Mexico. He'll achieve this by overthrowing the government and becoming dictator.
In 5 years, I see Rachel Leach and Austin Secor living in Mark and Gina's basement with 2 kids and $5.
All right, so me, Sam, Drew Smith, Bo Humphrey, and, oh God, he's the fifth member, Hunter Bolesky, are all going to be professional video gamers, and we're going to make lots of money off of it. That's all I have to say about that at this time.
I think that Jenny Neiman is going to graduate college and start a nightclub called the Smoky Cat.
Me and Drew, we're going to start to be a tag team in the WWE. We're going to wear just underwear, duke it out with a bunch of big men.
All right, in the future, I see Lane Yoder becoming a Mormon and marrying all of the Marvel superheroes and all the actors that play them. And I think she's going to move to California to be with all of these superheroes, and she's going to be in all their movies with them and basically become obsessed like she already is.
I think Devin, he's going to be a very successful young man in his very nice cardboard box. Sorry, maybe outside of Chicago.
In Maverick's future, I can see him being the first male Dallas Cowboys cheerleader. He'll probably lift a girl up, but drop her, get sued, end up in jail.
Well, Wilson's going to try out for the Cincinnati Reds. Instead of making the team, he's going to break his leg and then become one of the sweeper-upper guys in the middle of the seventh inning that comes in, and they play like jumbo dancing, whatever, and then he'll become a mascot, and then he'll die at age 52.
When Maddie Hance becomes a businesswoman, she is going to start casual everydays and show up to work to be a lawyer or something in shorts and a t-shirt, and everything's just going to be super chill. She's a chill girl.
I think Zach Aino will never get married, stay at the Ohio Caverns rest of his life, and die at 40.
All right, Megan is going to marry Michael, clearly, because everyone knew. And then her and Michael are going to live in Veronica's basement with their 12 kids and 6 dogs. And they'll probably have a goldfish or 2 and a guinea pig, because why not?
I see Ben Bowden in the future playing in Hungary with me, of course, and he's going to be working at Goodwill.
So at this time, I would like to apologize to you, as I was informed that I am most likely to lie about being able to see the future. My friends, family, producer, and writers, and random people on the streets have informed me that I'm a liar, and I need to apologize to you and the rest of society. So let us see what others are most likely to do. And hopefully they don't get as much hate and awful, awful things written on their car. Couple broken windows. Can we stop that, please?
Yeah, okay. Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Space Jam. Here's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. Alright. All right.
Baby boy, the prince. Meantime, old Cash Monroe. Extreme entertainment.
Ooh, ooh. This is the way I live.
real boy, still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live. Little boy, still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill.
So right here is where I became the number one host of a 2015 West Liberty Salem senior video. It's a really, really impressive board. It also happens to be the same place I fought off the devil and survived, so that's nice. So let's see where else people did awesome stuff. Hopefully some more people fought off the devil.
This is where I play basketball, and I enjoyed this because it's where I got to enjoy high school. It made me enjoy the person I am with sports, and I wish I could continue on the next level, but it was fun to have all the memories, and I hope that I can coach here again one day.
This is where I spent all day relaxing after lunch. It's one of my favorite places in the whole school.
This is where I got MVP and broke a couple records.
This is where I got bullied several times freshman year and I couldn't do anything about it.
This is where I got my pants pulled down by Drew Smith in third grade.
This is where I learned to cook, and this is where I have a lot of memories.
This is where I take naps during school. It's my favorite place.
Okay, this is where I came to eat some snacks and form a close relationship with our athletic director because he's such a hard worker.
My favorite spot in the school is the locker room because there's no teachers to watch us and we can pick on underclassmen.
This is where I almost punched Kylie Harmon in the face junior year because she tripped me at track practice.
This is where I walked in my freshman year and tripped and fell in front of all the seniors. It was really embarrassing.
This is where I dunked my first basketball in a game.
This is where B. Holy said that he couldn't play football anymore.
So I hope this video is a great memory for you to look back on when you're 25, 35, or when you're really old. But with the end of this video comes the end of my career of hosting senior class videos. So, thank you for having me.
And to think, until that last scene you were doing good. Then you sucked it up again, buddy.
You know what? That means a lot to me, man. I'm just, thank you. Thank you so much.